Everybody, thanks for logging on for your forecast. It is a huge mess that is developing across the Gulf states right now. You've got a huge cluster of storms, big tornado watch over Mississippi, big tornado watch over Alabama. That little purple box there, our red tornado warning boxes turn purple when they are confirmed tornadoes. So this is an ongoing threat that is happening all across southern Mississippi and Louisiana. And just the rainfall amounts have been just outrageous across parts of Louisiana and Texas. 10 to 15 inches of rain so far has fallen just today from this particular system. So needless to say, we're watching it very closely. I will say, though, that it still looks like the vast majority of any severe weather we're going to see from this is going to be confined to the Gulf states down towards Mississippi and Alabama. And as that system pushes east, it's going to kind of fan out a little bit. And both the severe weather threats for tomorrow are stretched across the Ohio Valley and down towards south central Georgia and the Florida Panhandle. We're still just looking at a low overall threat. I will say maybe the timing is the only subtle difference. I think from around 4 a.m. to around noon is when we're expecting the storms. I was thinking earlier it'd be a little bit shorter from 5 to 11, but needless to say, we are watching it very closely. At least for now, the rain we've seen so far today has been pretty light. It's let up quite a bit in the upstate in northeast Georgia. I think some parts of the area probably even getting some sunshine, probably down towards Abbeville and Greenwood, but we're still kind of socked in with the clouds in Greenville, Spartanburg sitting at 60 and 59 degrees. Those clouds have really helped to keep temperatures right where they have been all morning long. Not warming up that much, that's for sure. 63 in Anderson and 57 in Asheville. So here's the hour by hour. Rest of the day today, again, we're going to see more breaks in the clouds and a bit of a hiatus in the rain before the storms really ramp up heading into early tomorrow morning. One thing you'll notice late tonight is the winds are going to pick up quite a bit. After sunset, those gusts will get up to around 20 miles per hour. When you wake up early in the morning, it's going to be more like 25 to 30 miles per hour. And this little batch of rain is going to be from a decaying batch of storms that'll be farther back to the west. That'll probably be heading in at around 10 to 11 p.m. And here comes our storm window. Notice the little impact icon there. From around 4 a.m. to noon, be on guard for some possible severe thunderstorm warnings. And we can't totally rule out an isolated spin-up tornado. Again, looks like a low overall threat, but just have your guard up just in case as these waves of storms come in. Then once the storms are over, into the afternoon, once the coverage of the rain really backs off, the winds, man, they're really going to pick up. We're talking about 40 mile per hour gusts tomorrow, all the way up to 50 miles per hour potentially across parts of western North Carolina. So yes, your trash can's probably going to go flying down the street, possibly into your neighbor's yard, because we're talking about some pretty strong gusts here. So anything, main message here is just anything that's loose fitting out on the porch or out on the deck, you want to bring it inside, especially as these wind gusts pick up again to around 35 to 40 miles per hour, not just for tomorrow, but for Friday as well. Very dynamic system that is moving through, so something to be aware of as you head into the next couple of days. So here's what I've got for the 4-day. Two impact days here, Thursday and Friday. Thursday's for the storms and the wind. Once we dry out Friday, it's mostly just going to be because of the high winds that'll still be there. Good news is, rest of the weekend looks fantastic. It'll be sunny and calmer with highs in the upper 70s Saturday, warming up to the low 80s on Sunday, and we'll keep with low 80s next week. It actually kind of starts to feel like what it should this time of year, which is it's Masters week. So you expect upper 70s, low 80s. That is what we're going to get later on this weekend. 40 plus to the mountains looks like this. It's going to stay windier for slightly longer during the day. Saturday, we'll still have gusts, possibly up to around 25, 30 miles per hour. But then on Sunday, things start to calm down a little bit. But that being said, still a pretty nice weekend forecast. Lots of sunshine, no chance of rain, and warming up into the start of next week. Have a great rest of your Wednesday, everybody.